I'm about to read two Bible passages that contain a supposed contradiction, and I want you to take a little time and see if you would be able to explain to someone else why there's not actually a contradiction there. I'll put both passages on the screen so that you can compare them, and feel free to pause this video so that you can examine each passage more clearly. Matthew chapter 20, verses 29 through 30. And as they departed from Jericho, a great multitude followed him. And behold, two blind men sitting by the wayside, when they heard that Jesus passed by, cried out, saying, "Have mercy on us, O Lord, thou Son of David." Mark chapter 10, verses 46 through 47 records the same event. And they came to Jericho, and as he went out of Jericho with his disciples and a great number of people, blind Bartimaeus, the son of Timaeus, sat by the highway side begging. And when he heard that it was Jesus of Nazareth, he began to cry out and say, "Jesus, thou son of David, have mercy on me." I'm Cole, you're watching Practical Faith. In this video, we're going to dig into a strategy for reconciling these two passages. This video is part of a collaboration between myself and Thaddeus from Reason Answers Apologetics videos. Links to his channel and the playlist are included in the description below, so be sure to sub to both of our channels so that you don't miss any future installments. These videos are not just to tackle specific supposed contradictions in the Bible, although we are going to address a few specifically, but our broader goal is to be able to teach other Christians how to think about these supposed contradictions when you come across them. The strategy I want to discuss in this video is understanding that omission is not contradiction. In the passages that we read, Matthew mentions two blind men, but Mark only talks about one blind man. But that doesn't mean that there wasn't another blind man present. Now, if Mark had said there was only one, then there would be a contradiction. But just because he omitted the other man, he didn't talk about him, that doesn't mean he wasn't there. Let me give you an example. Let's say that I was in a conversation with a young couple about my relationship with my wife before we got married. And I say, "Yeah, she had three older brothers, and that was a little bit intimidating." Then I talk to somebody else later in the day, and I say, "Yeah, my wife has four brothers." Well, who did I lie to? I didn't lie to anyone, right? Because she does have three older brothers and a younger brother. I omitted the information about her younger brother in the first conversation because I really wasn't worried about the younger brother. The older brothers are big and they can beat me up, but the younger brother, he's like three, and so he's not that tough. Just because I omitted that information in one story doesn't mean I contradicted the other story. It could be that Mark, who only talked about blind Bartimaeus, was just emphasizing the leader. Or maybe he knew Bartimaeus since he called him by name, or he knew his father, Timaeus, since he also used his name. It also could be true that Bartimaeus was the loudest of the two, or that later on, at the time of Mark's writing, he had become more well-known within the church. We don't know, but all of these are likely possibilities. The point is that the differences here are not contradictions, but they're just differences in perspective. The Bible was written by men, but these men were moved upon by the Holy Spirit to bring us the Word of God, but they were still men. They still had their own personalities, their own occupations, their own interests, biases, circle of friends, and so a lot of that is going to come through when they're writing. So you can have two men seeing the exact same event unfold, and when they write about it, you're going to see different details coming out of each man's account. If everything in the Gospels was exactly the same, then we might have more reason to question it. J. Warner Wallace, former cold case homicide detective, writes, "I'm not sure why you would expect the Bible authors to report things in precisely the same way. Why wouldn't there appear to be contradictions? This is the nature of all reliable eyewitness testimony. When multiple people witness a crime, one of the first things that the detectives do is separate the witnesses so that they don't collude. The detectives want to hear each perspective, and then later they'll go through and piece the story together to figure out what actually happened." So once again, omission is not the same thing as contradiction. If you'd like some practice using this strategy to reconcile Bible passages, then you might check out the event of Jesus delivering the demoniac. And you may also take a look at the accounts of the women who discovered Jesus's empty tomb. I'll include the scriptures for both of those events in the description below. If you've enjoyed this video, please like and subscribe if you haven't already. Also, please remember to subscribe to Thaddeus' channel and turn on the bell notification, because there's a good chance you're not going to see the next video unless that bell is on. Until then, thanks for watching. Mark chapter 10, verses 46 through 40. Bah! Bruh! This video is a part between myself and Thaddeus from Reason Answers Videos Apologetics.